What's up, John Charette here, and today I want to tell you why I think Garlicoin is still the best coin to mine. I want to tell you how to solo mine and what that means, and also what my overclock settings are. What's up? Welcome back. If this is your first time here, we like to talk about different side hustles, particularly mining cryptocurrency right now. So this is all about Garlicoin. Now Garlicoin had a hard fork 7 days ago, and I've been mining it ever since. It's awesome. By far, my favorite coin to mine right now for a couple reasons. First, it runs way cooler on my video cards than any other currency, like 10 degrees cooler. Now, what does that mean? I mean, it means that your card, the longevity of your cards will last longer. It's less heat coming out of my basement. Right now it's coming, we're kind of close to spring. It's getting warm out and I'm a little bit worried what I'm gonna do with all the extra heat in the basement. So the cooler I can keep that, the better. And I'm starting to run my fans on auto. Whereas before I had them at like 95 or 100% all the time. Now it's fine. I put on auto, they run at like 60%, 70%. So the audible noise level in the basement or in my home office here is a lot less for the GPU, which is awesome. So putting that aside, it's profitable, super profitable. Comparing it to Z Classic that I was mining before, it pulls in Z Classics in at like $35 US a day with my rig, which is 11080 and 7 1080 Ti's, which is like $50 Canadian. Or Garlicoin is pulling in like $55 US, more like $70, $75 Canadian. So, two thumbs up. Next, I want to talk solo mining. A few days ago, here, I'll show you. I was on the Discord channel and someone posted that they released a solo miner. Now, what does that mean? So, in my first video, I talk about Mahanmarin, Garlicoin, Allium Hard Fork. We use Supernova, we connect to a pool, and we end up using the CCMiner 2.30 for the Nvidia cards. Works great, awesome, cool, but it doesn't do solo mining. So this guy released this one, I said, cool, I wanna check it out, what's the deal? Now, solo versus pool, I think most people with smaller rigs pool, because the idea is that everyone gets together and the pool requests a block and shares from the blockchain, and you typically get paid out proportionally. So if I have 100 mega hash, you get paid out regardless of if you specifically find a coin or not or solve a block, you end up getting paid based on how much you've contributed to the pool. I know from my scenario, because I've had to convince my significant other to spend money and build a mining rig, right? It's an investment. I need to be able to give her some numbers and say, okay, well, I expect to make this many coins over 1 month, 3 months, 6 months, 1 year, and approximate value. So I know when I spend $10,000 on a new rig, that how long the estimated payback and return of investment will be. If you're solo mining, it's random. You and only you request a block with shares from the network, and you say, hey, okay, I'm solved the problem. Did I solve the problem? Nope. Okay, nope. Oh, I might solve the problem, and then you get a reward. Now, every currency has a different reward. In the case of Garlicoin, it's a 50-block reward. So what does that mean? I mean, you have to kind of consider, okay, well, how many do I make in a day if I pool versus I solo? So let's look at that really quick. If we look at the dashboard for Supernova, I have earned 1,528 coins over the past seven, we'll say 7.5 days, sure. So divided by 7.5, 200 coins a day. Awesome, cool. So now if I'm solo mining, I would have to solve four blocks, four times 50 to make the same amount. Will I find those blocks? No one knows. You can literally go all week and not find a block, or you can find 10 blocks in a row. It is completely random. So for me, I like the comfort of the proportional-based payout system, but if you want to try solo mining, if you have a lot of hash power, if you have like a farm and a lot, That's where solo mining comes, and it could be more profitable. So here, I'll show you how to do it. First, you need to grab this special release of CCMiner, solo miner. I will put a link. Okay, download that and put it somewhere on your computer. Here's the old one, okay, that I'm using for Supernova. Old, you know, the solo one here. Okay, so I extracted it into this folder, and it comes with a bat file. So you open up the bat file, you can see here it says CCMiner. Awesome, the algorithm, and it points locally to your own computer with a port of 42,068. Now we need to keep in mind that port, username test, password test, and a mining address, okay? And the rest is, don't need to worry about that. Okay, so what I did is I made a new one. Let's open this up and let's compare the two, old to new. Great. So I kept it pretty much the same port. I just changed the address. So where do you get your Garlic wallet address? Well, kind of like I talked about in my first video, this one here, how to mine Garlic coin. I use the Windows-based wallet called Garlic Core. Now, it is absolutely necessary for you to use this system for solo mining. Here's why. So I have it open here. I'll send a link to install it. Once you install it, it actually reaches out to the network and downloads an entire copy of the blockchain, which is cool. It takes like 10, 20 minutes. Now, because it has a copy of the blockchain and keeps that updated at all times, you can now solo mine and request a block, and it keeps everything in sync. So as soon as you run this, one, you want to get your receiving address, which is your Garlic coin address. Just go to file, receiving addresses, and you have your address there. You can hit copy, come down to your, I'm going to use the old one here as an example, paste in your Garlic address, save it. That's it. You're good for your bat file. Don't need that anymore. Okay. But by default, if you try and run it, it will not be able to connect to the Garlic coin network. What we need to do is edit the configuration file. So first, close Garlic coin core and go find the file where the Garlic coin config is. It's located in your C users, whatever your username is, my case is Johnny, and then AppData Roaming Garlic Coin. Know that AppData is a hidden folder. So if you just go to users and your account, you will not find it. You have to type in AppData, then you'll see roaming, and then you can find Garlic Coin. Okay. So you'll see garlicoin.config. It may not have a nice little fancy note symbol, maybe blank like this one. If you double click on it, it'd be the same as going to open with. It'll say, what do you want to open with? If you click this more apps button, you'll find notepad in the list. Double click notepad and open it up. It will be completely empty. That's normal, don't freak out. I will paste all this information here into the notes below. Copy and paste it in. We're using the username password test, same as in our batch file. Okay, this is saying allow IPs from someone on our network, which is cool. And then you want to use the port of 42,068. Okay, all that matches up, awesome. These are addresses of the nodes to connect to grab the information. So once that's in, save the file and then run your Garlic coin wallet again. Where did I lose it already? Wallets, Garlic coin, run it again. Once it is running, now you're good to go. So let's go back to solo mine, run your new bat file, and now it's working. Now you can see it's connecting to the network. You can see it finds the card, zero, GPU zero. This is my 1080 rig, okay? And it's starting to pull in. You'll see the hash rate intensity is set to 21, and it starts to mine. So you can see here we have a hash rate of 4,600 kilohash with an intensity of 21. That's pretty good. That seems to be where I like it best. In my last video right here, I talk about hash rates and intensity. Okay, putting your intensity at 21 is like a 10% increase. So awesome. Okay, so you can see here it's ranging, kind of like bounces between 44 to 45, 4,600 kilohash, which is awesome. So I don't know. I haven't watched this and just sit here and watch it to find out if this miner will actually say you found a block. I know in the other one, the CCMiner X64, it'll actually say yay, it'll have an exclamation point, which is pretty cool. But I haven't sat here and watched this one enough to see if it does it. But what I do want to show you is my overclock settings. So currently, if I jump into MSI Afterburner, I'll pull this up here a little bit, maybe like this. Okay, these are my current settings. Power limit is at 100. I have tried dropping down to 70. I thought I lost quite a bit of hash when I did that, so I'm leaving it at 100. My rig downstairs is at 70, which is helping with the heat even more. Awesome. And my power draw. Core clock is overclocked 100 megahertz, and my RAM, my memory, is downclocked by 500. So, because of that, once again, less heat and even better. So, you see it sitting here 46, 46, 44, 44, 45. Let's play with this and put it back to stock. 0, 0, little check mark. And within like a block, or I mean a share or two, it will show the difference right away. See how it just dropped from 4,500 down to 4,300. Now it's not like huge difference, but I like it. I mean, the fact that I can underclock my RAM and overclock the core just a tiny little bit. I recommend if you put it at 100 and your computer freezes or reboots, that's okay. Just reboot it up, back up, and reset everything back to zero. I suggest overclocking your core by increments of 25. Try that out, see if it works, see how it holds. And you see here it's sitting at about 4,300 consistently. So I was getting 4,500, 4,600. So I'm getting an extra 2 to 300 kilohash, which is a 5% increase. So not bad. Looking at the coin itself, you can see here it is. It's still sitting at 25 cents. I mean, when I started, it was at 50 cents, but it dropped down to 25. It's been floating around 25, 30, which is awesome. Oh, here it is right here. This is the 16th. It was up right when the hard fork happened. It kind of went up and then it's been just kind of floating down here, but it's actually on a nice little increase. So who knows? Like I say, those calculations that I gave you, those were at 25 cents. So I watch it every day. I mean, I'm here to kind of keep mining away. I always say my strategy is mine and hold, mine and hold. So if you have any questions, other overclock settings, how do you prefer solo mining over pool mining? If so, let me know how it's going. I want to hear what your hash rate is and how many blocks you're able to solve to determine can you get, like say in my case, can you solve more than 4 blocks a day to make it worth it? All right, guys, see you later. Thanks. Thanks again for watching. If you want to learn more about earning passive residual income, please subscribe. I'm here to pass along my knowledge so you can take action. See you next time.